Health doesn't solve all problems, but you give it as a gift so that we can share that together. And I just pray as they go forward that you will lead them into your perfect purpose for their lives, that they'll continue to have joy in all they do, that they will celebrate your love. And God, we pray that they will represent you as they move forward. So we ask your blessings on them. We give their future to you. For it's in Christ's wonderful name we pray. Amen. Well, Bruce, it's time, my man. I think your beautiful new bride needs a kiss. Nothing like a sweaty one, huh, on a warm day. Why don't you turn and face your family and friends and receive your bouquet? Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great joy to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Bruce Merriman. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming. And let me tell you what's getting ready to happen. You can see them moving over to this side. They would love to have a group picture of everybody who came. So if you can, go ahead, just make your way over here. Be very careful. Don't go too far that way. You don't want to go down the mountain too quick. But join them for a great picture.
Yeah.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you light up the dark. Try as I may, I could never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. Touch of your heart says you'll catch me if ever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talking out loud. But when you hold me near, you drown out the crowd. Oh, Mr. Webster could never define what's being said between your heart and mine. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me if ever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes reach of your hand says you'll catch me if ever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all.
Jesse and Bruce, Lee, Grace, and I, Jonathan and Josiah are so happy for you. When you find the love of your life and the Lord is in your life, even though hard times may come, it's the best thing ever. And you think about how much you love each other today and in this moment, but as you share your life together with Christ, you're going to grow in your love so much more, and I'm so excited for you guys to get to experience that together. We give you our best wishes.
Hi, Jessica. I'm so glad we got to be a part of this. It's a beautiful setting. You all were wonderful. I loved your vows. You could tell God was in the ceremony. I've long prayed that that God would just bless you this way, and I know you and Bruce are going to be so happy together, and I'm just thrilled to have been a part of it, and we love you so much, and God bless you.
Bruce and Jessica, this was a wonderful day. I'm sure in God's grace it'll be the first of many to come. Just stay happy. Bye.
Mm-hmm. Bruce and Jessica, congratulations. I'm worshiping my boy. I love you, Bruce, and I love you, Jesse. Take care of each other and enjoy each other. And I love you both.
Jessica and Bruce, I'm so happy for you, and Jesse, I'm so happy to be a big part of your life again, and I hope that continues as you guys grow as a family, and as you make a family of your own, and getting our kids together, and all that, and I look forward to those days, and I'm just so thankful to be down here and to get to witness such a beautiful wedding where God is really going to be the center of a marriage, and that's so encouraging, and we love you very much, and we hope you have a good time. Jessica and Bruce, we feel very excited and blessed that we've been able to take part in your special day, a gorgeous ceremony. You're a beautiful couple, and we are so thankful that the Lord let you find each other, and we just wish you His blessings and every happiness in your future. Thanks. Hey, Bruce and Jess, we're just so happy for you. Congratulations on your wedding today. It's a God-made thing. As you know, Jess, your mom and I have been praying for years for that right person to come along, and not only were we blessed by a good one, but you got the best. And so you two are made for each other, and I'm so excited to see how you're going to serve the Lord together, and we'll be praying for your continued life together in your marriage.
And Bruce always say, yes, dear. Bye.
That was good.
Has that thing started? Jessica, I love you.
Okay, keep going.
First, this has been a beautiful day. I made it through my part without crying.
You want her to be recording this or not?
Did you shut it back off?
I've got it, yeah.
You've got it wrote off or on?
On.
That's what I thought. Okay. She didn't when I started again. I thank God for who you are. And you know how I feel. Bruce, I love you too. Take care of my baby.
I was fine till Dad started talking. You know what you mean to me, and you'll always be my baby. Bruce, you know, we've come to love you as well, and accepted you into our family a long time ago.
And we wish nothing but God's best for both of you. And I'm so proud of you for the way that you have come around to the Lord.
Yes.
And I know that you'll be an awesome head of the family.
Yeah.
And in 3 to 5 years, you two will make beautiful children together.
That's it.
Hey Jesse, we're really glad that we could make it up here today. I want to give you two things that I think are critically important for a marriage that's going to last and do well. The first is kind of heavy, and the other is a little lighter, but plays into the heavy. You guys spoke about Genesis chapter 2 today. Well, in Genesis 2, we also see the purpose of marriage, that one would come alongside us that would bring a sense of completion to us, and at the same time, be a partner for mission. The Bible says there that we're to be fruitful and multiply. Now, we know in the world that we live in that fruitfulness, that we would bear fruit in everything that we do is resisted, and it's difficult in a fallen world that's so deeply affected by sin. That's why He gives us each other, so that we can work together for the accomplishing of His mission on the earth, that we might advance the gospel in every way that we possibly can. And that's the heavy part. Now, Sarah said just a minute ago that in 3 to 5 years you guys are going to have beautiful children. Well, I want to encourage you to practice making beautiful children lots and lots up to that 3 to 5 year period, because that's one of the ways that we can be fruitful and multiply. Certainly not the only way, but I want to encourage you guys to enjoy life, have a wonderful time together. You guys spoke of being best friends. It is such a critical element in marriage. I do want to encourage you, however, to not take too seriously the words of the Alison Krauss song that Tara sang. It's actually bad marital theology. You need to talk a lot. You need to communicate. You need to tell him how you feel, because he can't guess. He's not a mind reader, and you're going to think that he's just supposed to know. Well, I've been married for 16 years, and I still don't know what I'm supposed to know. I need her to tell me. So you guys talk a lot, communicate, love on each other, respect, cherish each other, and you guys will have a great, long-lasting covenant marriage. We love you guys, and we're glad that we were able to be a part of this today.
And we're here if you need us. We love you.
See you guys.
She got her hug and a picture.
Soulmate, until the end of time, you're my soulmate. I'll love you till I get to heaven's gate. And if I go first, sweetheart, I'll wait. 'Cause I know I'll never find another soulmate. Your love, there's no telling where I'd be without your love. Stumbling in the dark would be pretty rough. When I get down, you're the one that lifts me up. And I thank the Lord above for your love. In this day and time, the right one's hard to find. Girl, that's why I'm holding on to you. Each and every night when we turn out the light, there's no mistaking what we have is true. Soulmate, then we grow old together, soulmate, in the good and bad, even through the heartache. We've got a special bond that'll never break. 'Cause darling, you and I